हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ स्वरदा समीर मोने एंड आई एम फ्रॉम ईएनटीसी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बीबीसीओईडब्ल्यू। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस यूनिट फोर्थ ऑफ डेटा साइंस, दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू मशीन लर्निंग। एंड इन दिस वी विल कवर फ्यू कॉन्सेप्ट्स एंड द एमसीक्यूज ऑफ टॉपिक्स लाइक व्हाट इज मशीन लर्निंग, द टाइप्स ऑफ मशीन लर्निंग, द एप्लीकेशंस एंड द इश्यूज ऑफ मशीन लर्निंग। एंड इट विल बी डिलीवर्ड बाय माई टीम मेट्स मिनल कोरे, सिद्धि जाधव and Purva Komas Pillewar. And I hope by the end you will get your concepts clear and it will also help you for preparing the MCQs of this particular unit. So let us start with our first topic by Meenal Gore. Over to you, Meenal.
Hello everyone, my name is Meenal Gore. I am from ENTC department from BBCOIW. So today we will discuss about what is machine learning, well-posed learning problems and designing learning systems. And then we'll discuss about some MCQs.
First topic is, what is machine learning? According to Arthur Samuel, machine learning is the field of study that gives computer the capability to learn without being explicitly programmed. So machine learning can be defined as a process where computers learn by themselves and improvise the learning process based on the experience they get, which means without any human guidance. So the process starts by giving the data and algorithm to the machine, where algorithm depends on the amount of data we have and what task we expect it to do, and then training it with these data and algorithm. So according to this diagram, the machine learning is given data and output as the input, and it creates its own logic or program which can be evaluated while testing. Machine learning can be classified in three major categories depending on the nature of the learning. Those are supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning, which you will learn more about it further in this video. So our next topic is well-posed learning problems. A computer program is set to learn from experience E in context to some task T and some performance measure P if its performance on T, as was measured by P, upgrades with experience E. I know it must sound you a little bit tricky one, but it's really easy. So whenever we are assigned with a problem, it is said to be a well-posed learning problem if it has three traits: task, performance measure, and experience. So as the word task says, the task is what we assign to the program. Performance measure is what we wish our goal to be for that machine. And experience is, in this whole process, what we train our machine and what it gained by that. So let it understand more with the help of an example. In an example of fruit prediction problem, the task is forecasting different fruits for recognition, which means our main task is for the machine for it to recognize different types of fruits. The performance measure for it would be that it should, when we place a maximum number of fruits or variety of fruits in front of it, it should be able to predict the maximum variety. And the experience through all this training would be that the machine should learn the largest data sets of fruits images. So our next topic is, design a learning system in machine learning. So according to Arthur Samuel, machine learning enables a machine to automatically learn from data, improve performance from an experience, and predict things without explicitly programmed. So while designing this whole learning system, we have to deal with at least these four following issues. Machine has to deal with these four things. Those are training experience, target function, learn function, and learning algorithm. I'll explain it more with the help of this diagram. So when machine learning algorithm is fed with the training data, it produces logical mathematical model, which would make a prediction and which would help the machine to take its own decision. Also, while feeding the machine, the more data, the more it would gain, the more experience. And if it would gain the more experience, the more it will be it would produce the efficient result. So the more experience it gets, the more efficient it becomes. So let us study an example of a driverless car. So the training for it would be that the algorithm which we feed to the training data is how to drive the car in highway, in busy roads, in narrow streets, considering the factors like speed limit, parking, stopping at signal, and etc. After considering these whole factors, a logical mathematical model is being created. And after that, considering with the help of this logical model, the car will work according to it without being explicitly programmed. Also, the more data we feed to the algorithm, the more efficient it would be, and yeah, it would produce a more efficient output. So let us move to our MCQ session. So our first question would be, what is true about machine learning? Machine learning is a field of computer science. Machine learning is a type of artificial intelligence that extracts patterns out of raw data by using an algorithm or method. The main focus of ML is to allow computer systems learn from experience without being explicitly programmed or human intervention or all of the above. So all the statements are true, as the statements in this options in A, B, and C are the definition of machine learning and what the machine learning exactly does. So our answer would be all of the above. So our next question is, ML is a field of AI consisting of learning algorithms that options are over time with experience, improve with performance at executing some task, or all of the above. So as we studied under the well-posed learning problems, that a problem is classified in three traits based on which learning happens. Those are task, performance, and experience. So based on them, the learning algorithms are to improvise their performance at executing some task over time with experience. So are all the three options A, B, C are correct? These three things are under the well-posed learning problems. So our answer would be all of the above. So next is, which of the following are ML methods? Unsupervised learning, supervised learning, semi-reinforcement learning, or all of the above. So as we studied earlier, that ML methods are classified depending on the nature of learning, and those were unsupervised, supervised, and reinforcement. And semi-reinforcement is also there, but the main three factors ML is categorized are supervised, unsupervised, and reinforcement. But semi-reinforcement learning is also there. So our correct option would be all of the above. So our next question is, what is machine learning? Artificial intelligence, deep learning, data statistics. So our options are only one and two, all and none. So the relationship between machine learning, artificial intelligence, and deep learning is that deep learning is the subset of machine learning, and machine learning and deep learning both are the subset of artificial learning, and data statistics comes under those topics. So our answer would be artificial intelligence and deep learning, which means B, both A and 1 and 2. So our next question is, which of the following is not for supervised learning? So our options are naive-based, PCA. PCA stands for principal component analysis, and linear regression, and decision tree. So as we studied earlier, the naive-based, linear regression, decision tree are all supervised learning. They make their decisions on their own, but principal component analysis is an unsupervised technique which is used to pre-process and reduce the dimensionality of the high-dimensional data sets, while to preserve the original structure. So our answer is PCA, principal component analysis. So moving on. Designing a machine learning process approach involves choosing the type of training experience, choosing the target function to be learned, choosing a representation for the target function, choosing a function approximation algorithm, or all of the above. So, as we studied under the design of machine learning, four issues that we need to deal with are training experience, target function, learn function, and learning algorithms. So these all four options, all these four issues are there in this option A, B, C, and D. So our correct answer would be E, all of the above. Moving on to the next question. What kind of learning algorithm for facial identities or facial expressions? So the question is what algorithm we need for facial identities. And the options are prediction, recognition patterns, generating patterns, recognizing anomalies. So prediction, predict if a machine is given with the data of facial expressions and facial identities of people, it doesn't need to predict something. Then recognition patterns is it needs to recognize the patterns if it has already a large amount of data of faces, and if we show another face, it needs to recognize the pattern. Generating patterns, we do not need to generate any pattern. So our C option is also incorrect. And D is recognizing anomalies, which we don't need right now. So the correct answer or the correct algorithm which we need for facial identity is recognition patterns. So moving on. Learning that enables massive quantities of data is known as artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, or all of these. So machine learning enables analysis of massive quantities of data, while it generally delivers faster, more accurate results in order to identify profitable opportunities. I know you might think that all are same and all of these should be the answer, but no, machine learning is faster, it delivers faster and more accurate results. So right now our answer is machine learning. Moving on, what is the main task of a problem solving agent? Solve the given problem and reach to goal. To find out which sequence of action will get it to the goals to the goal state, all of the mentioned, none of the mentioned. So eventually we need to solve the given problem as option A suggests, but we also need to look out for the sequence of action also, which option B states. So our correct answer would be C, all of the mentioned. So the set of actions for a problem in a state space is formulated by an intermediate state, initial state, successor function which takes current action and returns next immediate state, none of the mentioned. So intermediate state won't be the answer for this. Initial state is also not the correct answer as it would only suggest the initial state. Successor function is the correct answer as successor function is the only most common formulation for action. As given a, for example, as a given a particular task, successor returns a set of actions and the successors in ordered pairs, where each action is a legal action in particular state, and the successor is a state that can be reached just by applying the action to that particular state. So, successor function is the correct answer. It takes the correct action and returns the next immediate state. So our answer is option C. So our next question is, what is the major component or components for measuring the performance of problem solving? Completeness, optimality, time and space complexity, or all of the mentioned. So it should be completeliness. It should be optimality and it must be favorable, but also it should take less time to run and it shouldn't be too much lengthy for the user to read. So we need to consider all these three options. So our correct answer would be all of the mentioned. Moving on to our 12th question, which is what is used in determining the nature of the learning problem? Environment, feedback, problem, or all of the mention. So environment can be the answer, feedback can be the answer, problem can be the answer, and D, of course, all of the mention can be the answer. But the word feedback, learning from feedback is always the best useful in that way. It will learn what exactly user needs. Like feedback would help what the user exactly wants, and it would also give you what problem which you face while you created that algorithm. So yeah, feedback covers up with the problem and with the environment. So our answer would be feedback. The next question is, in general, to have a well-defined learning problem, we must identify which of the following: the class of tasks, the measure of performance to be improved, the source of experience, or all of the above. So as we started under the well-posed learning problem, that when a problem is assigned, it has three traits: task, performance, measure, and experience. Those all three are available in option A, B, and C. So our correct and desired option would be D, all of the above. So father of the machine learning is Geoffrey Chaucer, Geoffrey Hill, Geoffrey Everest Hinton, and none of these. So I guess you'll know it is Geoffrey Everest Hinton. I guess you guys don't need any explanation for this. The next is, any problem can be segregated as well-posed learning problem if it has task, performance measure, experience, all of these. So it is the which we are repeatedly talking about the well-posed learning problem. It consists of all these three. So task, performance measure, and experience. In short, it is a definition of well-posed learning problem. So our answer is all of these. So next question is, from the picture, what kind of programming is it? So the picture is a computer, and the input sources are data and output, and coming out from it is a program. And the options for it are traditional programming, machine learning, modern programming, traditional learning. Okay. So traditional programming is when we provide a machine with the data and program, and the output coming from it is the output. So obviously it would not be the traditional programming. And machine learning, yes, under the machine learning section we discussed about these. We feed in the data as input and the output which it runs on machine during this whole training session, and it creates its own logic or program which is evaluated while testing. So the correct answer for this is the machine learning. So our next question is, what kind of learning algorithm for future stock prices or currency exchange rates? Okay, so what we need here is the algorithm which we require for the future stock prices or currency exchange rates. So the options are recognizing anomalies, prediction, generating patterns, and recognition patterns. So recognizing anomalies is not what we require. Prediction, yes, we can predict for stock markets, obviously we can predict. Generating patterns, we do not need to generate any patterns, and recognition of patterns is also not required over here, because in stock, I don't think that in stock market we need recognition patterns. So the only thing that this only algorithm that needs for this future stock price or currency exchange rates would be prediction. So our answer would be prediction. So that's all from my side. I hope I covered all the possible questions related to these topics. And thank you so much. And over to you, Siddhi.
Hello everyone, my name is Siddhi Sagar from ENTC department of BVCOW, and my topic name is types of machine learning, supervised and unsupervised machine learning.
So let us start with the introduction of machine learning. So basically, what is machine learning? Machine learning is a method of data analysis that automates analytical model building. Basically, it is a study of computer algorithms that improves automatically through experience. And by use of data, it is seen as a part of artificial intelligence. It is mainly based on ideas that system can learn from data, identify pattern, and then make decisions. Today, examples of machine learning are all around us, like digital assistants search the web and play music in response to our voice command, spam detectors in email, and many more. It is a branch of artificial intelligence based on the ideas of system that can learn from data, identify patterns, and make decisions in minimal human intervention. Now, let us start with types of machine learning. Basically, machine learning algorithms are trained using three methods, which are supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. Now we are going to discuss about supervised and unsupervised learning methods. So, supervised learning. Supervised machine learning trains itself on labeled data set. It requires less training data than other machine learning methods and then makes training easier, because the result of model can be compared to actual labeled results. As we can see in figure, given input raw data is passed to algorithm and then it processes, and finally we get our output. The algorithm measures its accuracy through the loss of function, adjusting until the error has been sufficiently minimized. Supervised learning method can be separated into two types of problems when data mining, that are classification and regression. Moving to our next slide, unsupervised learning. Unsupervised learning is the type of algorithm that learns pattern from untagged data. Unsupervised machine learning ingests unlabeled data and uses algorithm to extract meaningful features needed to label, sort, and classify the data in real time without any human intervention. Unsupervised learning is less about automating decisions and predictions. Relationships in data can that human would miss. For example, take a spam detection. In that, people generate more emails than a team of data scientists could ever hope to label or classify in their lifetime. An unsupervised learning algorithm can analyze the huge volumes of emails that indicates the spam. Unsupervised learning algorithm allows the user to perform more complex processing tasks. These algorithms include clustering, anomaly detection, neural networks, etc. As we can see in the figure, raw data passes through translation, then algorithm, then it processes, and finally we get our output. Let us start with the MCQs now. So our very first MCQ is types of learning used in machine. Options are option A, supervised learning, option B, unsupervised learning, option C, reinforcement learning, and option D, all of the above. And our answer is option D, all of the above, because all of the mentioned machine learning methods are types of machine learning. Moving to our next MCQ, which of the factors affect the performance of learner system does not include? Our options are option A, representation scheme used, option B, training scenario, option C, type of feedback, option D, good data structure. And our answer is option D, good data structure, because factor that affects the performance of learner system does not include good data structure. Moving to our next MCQ, supervised learning and unsupervised clustering both requires which is correct according to the statement. Our options are option A, output attribute, option B, hidden attribute, option C, input attribute, and option D, categorical attribute. And our answer is option B, hidden attribute, because it heightens the security against hackers that are unable to access confidential data. Moving to our next slide, which of the following is best machine learning method? And our options are option A, scalable, option B, accuracy, option C, fast, and option D, all of the above. And answer is option D, all of the above, because all the methods are important and best machine learning methods. Moving to our next MCQ, which of the following is not type of learning? And our options are option A, unsupervised learning, option B, supervised learning, option C, semi-unsupervised learning, and option D, reinforcement learning. And answer is option C, semi-unsupervised learning, because main types of learning are unsupervised learning, supervised learning, and reinforcement learning. Moving to our next MCQ, what is supervised learning? Our options are option A, all data is unlabeled and algorithm learns to inherent structure from the input data. Option B, all data is labeled and algorithm learns to predict the output from input data. Option C, it is a framework for learning where an agent interacts with environment and receives a reward for each intervention. Option D, some data is labeled but most of it is unlabeled and mixture of supervised and unsupervised techniques can be used. And our answer is option B, all data is labeled and algorithms learn to predict output from input data because it is a definition of supervised learning. Moving to our next MCQ, what is unsupervised learning? And our options are option A, all data is unlabeled and the algorithm learns to inherent structure from the input data. Option B, all data is labeled and algorithm learn to predict the output from input data. Option C, it is a framework for learning where an agent interacts with environment and receives a reward in each interaction. Option D, some data is labeled but most of the unlabeled and mixture of supervised and unsupervised techniques can be used. And answer is option A, all data is unlabeled and algorithm learns to inherent structure from the input data because it is a definition of unsupervised learning. Moving to our next MCQ, which of the following is correct categorical outcome? And our options are option A, RMSE, option B, accuracy, option C, squared, and option D, all of the above. And our answer is accuracy, because accuracy judges the model by how many total correct predictions can be made. Moving to our next MCQ, supervised learning differs from unsupervised clustering and that unsupervised learning requires. Our options are option A, at least one input attribute, option B, input attributes to be categorical, option C, at least one output attribute, option D, output attributes to be categorical. And answer is option B, input attributes to be categorical, because supervised learning techniques can process both numeric and categorical input attributes. Moving to our next MCQ, which of the following does not include different learning methods? Option A, analogy, option B, introduction, option C, memorization, option D, deduction. And answer is option B, introduction. Because different learning methods include memorization, analogy, and deduction, it does not include introduction. Moving to our next MCQ. Targeted marketing, recommendation system, customer segmentation are applications in which of the following? Option A, supervised learning, classification. Option B, unsupervised learning, clustering. Option C, unsupervised learning, regression. And option D, reinforcement learning. Answer is option B, unsupervised learning, clustering. Because it is used for grouping similar entities together, help profile the attribute of different groups. Moving to our next MCQ. Fraud detection, image classification, diagnostic, customer retention are applications in which of the following? Option A, unsupervised learning regression. Option B, supervised learning classification. Option C, unsupervised learning clustering. Option D, reinforcement learning. And answer is option B, supervised learning classification. because it is a concept in which basically categorizes a set of data into classes. Moving to our next MCQ. Does the function provides unsupervised predictions? Which of the following is correct statement? Option A, CL precast. Option B, CL nowcast. Option C, CL forecast. Option D, all of the above. And answer is option D, all of the above, because the groups or clusters formed can be used to predict future, that is forecast, present, that is nowcast, and past, that is precast. Moving to our next MCQ. Automated vehicle is an example of option A, supervised learning. Option B, unsupervised learning. Option C, active learning. And option D, reinforcement learning. And answer is option A, supervised learning, because in automatic vehicle, set of vision, input, and corresponding actions are available to learner. Hence, it is an example of unsupervised learning. Moving to our next MCQ. Which of the following is also called as exploratory learning? Option A, supervised learning. Option B, active learning. Option C, unsupervised learning. And option D, reinforcement learning. Answer is option C, unsupervised learning, because in unsupervised learning, no teacher is available. Hence, it is called exploratory learning. Moving to our next MCQ. Naive-Bayes algorithm is dash learning algorithm. Option A, supervised. Option B, reinforcement. Option C, unsupervised. Option D, none of the above. And answer is option A, supervised, because for some type of probability model, naive-Bayes classifier can be trained very efficiently in supervised learning setting. Moving to our next MCQ. Which of the following is not application of unsupervised learning? Option A, document clustering. Option B, speech recognition. Option C, image compression. Option D, association analysis. And answer is option C, image compression, because in image compression, data takes up lesser storage when compressed, and as a result, this allows more data to be stored in less disk space. Thank you so much. Over to Purva.
Hello everyone. My name is Purva Komas Pillewar from ENTC department of BVCOEW, and my topics are reinforcement learning, applications of machine learning, and prospective and issuing machine learning.
Reinforcement learning is an area of machine learning concerned with how intelligent agent ought to take action in an environment in order to maximize the notion of cumulative reward. So reinforcement learning is an art of optimal decision-making process. So this definition is quite simple, because the systems would be there and you will perform some action, and system will also perform some action, and you will be there as an actor, and then will return you some set of action or some set of instruction. So that is basically how this work, and based upon this action, what you have, you will take the appropriate decision. So that is the basic force behind what the reinforcement learning is. There is RAM in the diagram environment. So in the environment, that is in the real world, let's say that I'm making this video. So this is the environment. So in the environment, I have state. So state is currently I'm making the video, that is state. Then comes the action. So I'm speaking, I'm communicating with you. So that becomes the action, and the reward is your feedback. So what is agent? So agent is me, that is actor. So agent will perform action based upon the action in the environment. So an environment is a big container. Inside that you have state. So state keeps on changing every now and then, and at every time period, state changes and the action also changes according with the state. So with each and every action, state gets triggered accordingly, and you will get the reward. Okay, this is how the reinforcement learning is. So the next topic is applications of machine learning. So machine learning is a buzzword for today's technology, and it's growing very rapidly day by day. We are using machine learning in our daily life, even without knowing, such as Google Maps, Google Assistant, Alexa. Below are some most trending real-world applications of machine learning, and that are shown in the figure. So, image recognition. The popular use of image recognition and face detection is automatic friend tagging suggestion. You all know Facebook, right? So Facebook provides us the feature of auto friend tagging suggestion. Whenever we upload a photo with our Facebook friend, then we automatically get a tagging suggestion with the name. The technology behind that is machine learning. Machine learning face detection and recognition algorithm. It is based on the Facebook project named DeepFace, which is responsible for face recognition. Okay, next is speech recognition. While we use Google, we get an option of search by voice. It comes under the speech recognition. Google Assistant, Siri, Alexa are used as a speech recognition technology to follow the voice instruction. Then there is the product recommendation. Machine learning is widely used by various e-commerce and entertainment companies like Amazon, Netflix for product recommendation to user. Whenever we search some product on Amazon, then we start getting an advertisement for some product while internet surfing on the same browser, and this is because of machine learning. There are various applications of machine learning. Among them is medical diagnosis. In medical diagnosis, machine learning is used as this technology is growing very fast and able to build a 3D model that help in finding the brain tumors and other brain-related diseases very easily. So there are a lot of applications of machine learning that we are using in our day-to-day life. So the next topic is prospective learning and issues in machine learning. Okay, prospective, it involves searching a very large space for possible hypothesis to determine that one that best fits the observed data and the issues, which algorithm perform best for which type of problem or representation, and how much training data is efficient. So this is how the prospective and issues of machine learning. We will go further with the MCQ. So the first is reinforcement learning is unsupervised learning, supervised learning, reward-based learning, and none. So the right C, award-based learning. Reinforcement learning is the award-based learning. Next, which of the following is an application? First option is topic modeling. Second, recommendation system, pattern recognition, and image classification. So the right option is B, recommendation system. Explanation, others are not the applications of reinforcement learning. Next, hidden Markov model is used in supervised learning, unsupervised learning, reinforcement learning, and all of the above. So D, all of the above. Hidden Markov model, especially known for their application in reinforcement learning as well as in supervised and unsupervised learning. Next, which of the following is true about reinforcement learning? First, the agent get reward or penalty according to the action. Second, it's an online learning. Third, the target of an agent is to maximize the reward. And D, all of the above. So D, all of the above. Reinforcement learning is an online learning platform where the target of an agent is to maximize the reward, as well as the agent gets the reward or the penalty according to the action. Which of the following is the most common application of machine learning? A, image recognition. B, self-driving cars. C, both A and B. And D, none of the above. So the right option is A, image recognition. Image recognition is the most common application of machine learning. It is used to identify object, person, place, digital image, etc. Speech recognition is an example of A, machine learning, B, artificial learning, C, D, none of the above. So the answer is A. Speech recognition is the process of converting voice instruction into text, which is the most popular application of machine learning. Next, machine learning is widely used by various e-commerce and entertainment companies such as A, Amazon, B, Netflix, C, both A and B, and D, none of the above. So the right answer is C, both A and B. Whenever we search for some product on Amazon, then we start getting an advertisement for that same product while the internet suffering on the same browser. And this is because of machine learning. It is an application of machine learning, actually. Next. Dash help us by checking whether it is a genuine transaction or a fraud transaction. A, feed forward neutral network. B, neutral network. C, all of the above. And D, none of the above. So A, feed forward neutral network. So for each genuine transaction, the output is converted into some hash values, and then this value becomes the input for the next round. For each genuine transaction, there is a specific pattern which get changes from the fraud transaction, and hence detect it and make our online transaction more secure. It is also an application of machine learning. Next, Dash is used for medical diagnosis. A, machine learning. B, data science. C, artificial intelligence. And D, none of the above. So the right option is A, machine learning. Explanation: medical technology is growing very fast and able to build a 3D model that predict the exact position of lesions in the brain. This is also an example of machine learning. Next, issue in machine learning: lack of quality data, inadequate infrastructure, implementation, and all of the above. All of the above. All of the above are the most common issue in machine learning. Next. Which of the factor affect the performance of the learner system does not include A, representation scheme used, B, training scenario, C, type of feedback, and D, good data structure. So the correct option is good data structure. Factors that affect the performance of the learner system does not include good data structures. Next, upper confidence bound is an A, reinforcement algorithm, B, supervised algorithm, C, unsupervised algorithm, and D, none of the above. So the correct option is A, reinforcement algorithm. Upper confidence bound is a deterministic algorithm for reinforcement learning that focuses on exploration and exploitation based on the confidence boundary that an algorithm assigned to a machine on each round of exploration. Next. Which algorithm is used in robotics and industrial automation? A, Thompson sampling, B, Navi Bayes, C, decision tree, and D, all of the above. So the correct option is Thompson sampling. Thompson sampling is an algorithm for choosing the action that addresses the exploration. Actions are performed several times and are called exploration. Next, the multi-arm bandit problem is generalized use case for A, reinforcement learning, B, supervised learning, C, unsupervised learning, and D, all of the above. So A, reinforcement learning. Multi-arm bandit is a classic reinforcement learning problem in which a player is facing with K slot machines or bandit, each with a different reward distribution, and the player is trying to maximize his cumulative reward based on trials. So the next is, which of the following is false about upper confidence bound? A, it's a deterministic algorithm. B, it does not lay feedback. C, it is not based on Bayes interference. D, none. All the statements mentioned above are true about upper confidence bound. Next, successful applications of machine learning. A, learning to recognize spoken words. B, learning to drive an autonomous vehicle. C, learning to classify new astronomical. D, all of this. Learning to recognize spoken words, to drive autonomous vehicle, to classify new astronomical structure are the applications of machine learning. So this is it. Over to you, Swarga.
Thank you, everyone. So here we conclude with all the MCQs of Unit 4 of Data Science. And I hope you understood all the concepts and MCQs explained by my teammates, Minal, Siddhi, and Purva. And if you have any doubt, please feel free to reach out to us. Thank you.